Hey guys. So, today we're just going to have a relaxing, softly spoken video. And what the heck am I doing? Well, what the heck we're doing today is we're going to paint this guy. Here I've already done two little sketches. This first one took about 10 minutes in watercolor, and that one I just didn't even draw, just kind of put the watercolor down for values. And this other one is a little concept that I might go with, and this is sort of like a green man kind of concept, or a fawn or something wild. Third concept we're gonna work on today. One, two, three. Third concept. So we'll go ahead and get rolling with that. And I have sped it up, starting about now, so that you guys wouldn't have to watch a whole 45 minutes of me doing this. Maybe you would enjoy that, I don't know. Tell me if you enjoy seeing the time lapse, or if you like seeing the drawing in real time, and if you do, I can try to make a longer video. So what I start with is just a circle, and then I am marking it off so I basically know where the eyes, nose, and mouth go. And then I'm gonna start just drawing in these shadow areas. Oh, really quickly, I wanted to say that Rick, who we're drawing, I found him on Instagram, and on Instagram he goes by Rick the Muse. Rick the Muse. Muse, 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 Muse. And lots of people enjoyed drawing Rick. He's just a really cool looking guy, and he takes a lot of fun photos. Actually, maybe his wife takes them of him, probably. But he'll dress up in different costumes and do some dramatic lighting and stuff. And he just has these photos up for free for anyone to work with who would like to. And I've done a few drawings of him. So right now, the reason I'm doing these little sketches is because I want to work on a larger portrait. And I'm fairly comfortable drawing him, so I thought that he would be a good person for me to do my first larger portrait using as a model. So right now I'm just trying to decide exactly what I want that portrait to look like, and I'd like to do something kind of fun and interesting with it, so I'm doing some small sketches in my sketchbook. Just doing these in graphite and watercolor. And then after I have done a few of them, I'm not sure how many yet, I will pick one and do an oil painting with it. So yeah, if you are interested in drawing Rick, I will put a link to his Instagram in the description of this video. Cracked up when I got to this part of the drawing because I thought it looked like Darth Vader. It's not going to look like Darth Vader in the end. What we're actually going to do in this drawing is I'm turning his beard into a circus tent. his mouth. So I need to figure out how to do a better transition there between his beard and the tent. So I might need to do this sketch again and play with it a little bit more. So actually, if any of you have suggestions, any tips, you can feel free to share those in the comments. Also, if you like one of these concepts better than the other, let me know that too, because I'm interested to hear what you think. I've always really liked drawing faces ever since I started drawing them. For me, it never gets boring to work with faces. I feel like even when I'm drawing the same person or even the same picture of a person, it can look so different every time. And actually in these little concept pieces, I'm not worrying too much about making it look like Rick. I'm sort of taking his features and accentuating the ones that I want to, and not worrying too much about if it's perfect. And I'm thinking that probably when I work on the larger portrait, I will try to make it look like him. But for these concept pieces, I'm just kind of getting the idea down. So now we're putting a little out of his head with a flag on it, and then I decided to add some more flags so that maybe we could have some more circus tents in the background. And here come those little tents, just kind of making these up. I started watching a series last night on YouTube that my artist friend Sarah Woods pointed out to me. She is a very talented artist who is working a lot with gouache right now, and I'll link to her Instagram too if you'd like to check that out. I would definitely recommend it. But she shared a link with me to a series that is a portrait competition, and it's a show from 2013. It's a British show, and I think it's called Portrait Artist of the Year. I don't know, maybe you guys have seen this, but if you're interested in watching it, I'll put that link. I know that at least the first two episodes are on YouTube. I don't know if the whole season is or not. So what they did was they have a whole bunch of artists send in self-portraits, and I think they received, oh my goodness, I can't remember what the number was, but it was like 1,800 self-portraits. And a committee of three judges went through them and chose, how many was it? Maybe 20 or so people to participate as contestants in this show. And so they come in and they are asked to paint portraits of people. So far it's been famous actors, British actors. They have 4 hours to do a complete portrait. And it was really cool to watch and very inspiring, because sometimes I can, as an artist, especially as a sort of beginning artist, I've only been doing this for a few years and only more seriously for probably 2 years, I would say, and even more seriously within the past year. Maybe you're always getting more serious, or maybe you're just learning. But it was was really neat for me because I am somebody who can kind of get really caught up in wanting what I do to be very technically correct, and I'll learn about a way of doing something and I'll sort of think, oh, okay, that's the right way to do it, so that's the way I need to learn how to do it. And while that's good and it builds skill, I find that sometimes I sort of stop enjoying what I'm doing if I'm too focused on the technical. And sometimes then I'll even freeze up and end up not making any art because I'll feel like I should sit down and do technical exercises, which I should. But I think it's also important to have fun, to keep always having fun with your art and doing what you like and what makes you happy. So I actually really enjoy doing these little concept pieces because I get to just play around and not worry too much about it being absolutely perfect. I can worry about that later. But hopefully every time that I even do one of these little sketches, I'm practicing and working and noticing what I'm doing right and wrong, and it's always great to get feedback. I have a couple people who do give me feedback, and especially one person who has been mentoring me, and I appreciate that so much because I learn so much more that way than when I'm doing it on my own, and I learn so much more from those critiques, you know, critiques from a knowledgeable person who really knows what they're talking about and can say, you know, if you just try this, that might work better, or, you know, you need to make the shadows darker here so that you can really get the form down, things like that. So, that helps a lot. And, anyway, so I was watching this portrait show. All of the artists went at the portraits from such different technical, just different, they all had different ways of doing things technically, and they were all working in different mediums. You know, there were watercolorists, and there were people who were doing charcoal drawings, there were pen and ink, I think, oil painting. I'm sure somebody was using acrylic. So it was just so neat to see all of these different artists approaching the portrait so differently. And each work, you know, was completely different from any of the others. And these were 20 different artists working. And so that was actually just very encouraging to me to see that there are many sort of right ways of doing this, and it made me just want to jump in there and do more with portraits. I think one of the things that I really like about portraits is that it doesn't have to be just copying a face. Like, you can do fun things like this, you know, you can have a circus tent coming out of someone's mouth, or paint flowers instead of a beard, or whatever you like. You know, you can incorporate all sorts of other genres into portraiture. You know, you could do a portrait in a landscape, you could do someone sitting next to a still life, you could do something very surreal or abstract, but still be working with portraiture. I love when I start doing the eyes because I feel like that's when it starts really sort of coming alive. Right now I'm still trying to get some of those shadows in. Shadows. And I forgot to say at the beginning, I always like to remind you guys because I like to be reminded when I'm watching or listening to ASMR. feel free to just relax and close your eyes if you would like. Even though I'm painting, you don't have to watch. You can always, you know, after you've fallen asleep and woken up, if you would like to skip to the end of the video, you can see the finished product. So, you absolutely have permission to fall asleep, to just close your eyes and relax, relax, relax. Now we're shading in those eye sockets. He has very deep set eyes. A little definition in or definition to the mouth, and I had kind of forgotten that ear over on that side, so I'm darkening that up. What kind of artwork do you guys like to look at? If you go to a museum, what kind of pieces really draw you in? Are you fans of more? The eyes. It's actually kind of useful to me to watch myself painting, even sped up like this, because I notice things. It could be actually kind of cool to do a portrait where you only really finish half the face. I sort of like that idea, but I feel like if I did that, I would want there to be a purpose for it. Like, a portrait that looks like the face isn't finished because I got lazy. So there would have to be some sort of reason for not finishing it completely. I kind of like it when artwork says something. I know that when you are properly working with watercolor, to make sure that the layers that you're putting down have time to dry. And I am not really doing that. They're mostly dry. Mostly dry. I used to think that portraits were very boring. I remember going to art galleries when I was young, and portraits were pretty much the last thing that I wanted to look at, because it just seemed like, here are these faces of people that I don't know, that were painted a long time ago, and I don't have any connection to them. And actually, I didn't really start enjoying portraiture until some more modern pieces. I really like modern art now. I also wasn't a big fan of modern art when I was younger. I'm kind of learning as I go, not to say that I don't like anything, because usually if I say I don't like something, it's because I don't really know anything about it. And once I learn about it, it's okay to change your opinion. I think it's good too. But I do think that one of the things that makes me interested in creating portraits is that I hope to create portraits that would not be boring to look at, that somebody could enjoy even if they don't. Gonna read you guys a quote or two about portraits, and the first one, unsurprisingly, is from the picture of Dorian Gray. passes, he discovers that whenever he ages or does something bad or wrong or evil, instead of aging in his own body or suffering any sort of ill effects because of whatever wrong thing he's done, his portrait instead ages and suffers those effects. It's a very interesting story, and one that I probably read every, I don't know, 5 or 10 years. But this is a quote from it, and you can let me know if you agree with this quote or not. I'm not sure that I do, maybe partly. So it says, "Every portrait that is painted with feeling is a portrait of the artist, not of the sitter. The sitter is merely the accident, the occasion. It is not he who is revealed by the painter. It is rather the painter who, on the colored canvas, reveals himself." And, of course, it's interesting that that's from Dorian Gray, because the picture of Dorian Gray, his portrait, really does end up revealing Dorian. I think that this quote often is true. I think when we create anything, you know, it's a lot to do with the person who is creating it. Just like how they say in a dream, you are all the characters that emerge in your dream. They all represent something about you. I think it's sort of the same when you're writing about someone, painting someone, it ends up saying a lot about you. And here is one last look. I will end with this quote. Let me see. It's a quote from Salvador Dali, and he says, "The reason some portraits don't look true to life is that some people make no effort to resemble their pictures." I am thankful to Rick for letting me draw his picture. I am thankful to you all for listening and watching.